Good evening and welcome to Rashtra Sabha News. My name is Aditi Nagpal Girodra. Let's get the news rolling with the headlines first. Upper House disrupted for the fifth day in a row due to standoff on the issue of Delhi violence. Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu advises government and opposition to hold consultations to ensure smooth functioning of the Rajya Sabha. Ahead of International Women's Day on 8 March, Chairman Naidu extends best wishes to women in the upper house, appreciates achievements of women in the country and the world, emphasizes need for their equal participation in legislative bodies as well as in policy formulation and implementation. And Parliamentary Standing Committee on Personal Public Grievances, Law and Justice recommends speedy recruitments to vacant posts in public institutions. Reports of other committees including Health and Family Welfare Department also presented in Upper House. Rajya Sabha witnessed disruptions on Friday over demands of immediate discussion on the recent violence in Delhi. Opposition parties continue to press for their demand to hold a discussion for the fifth consecutive day, leading to disruptions. As soon as the meeting of the upper house met for the day, some opposition members came to the well of the house and created uproar. Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu urged them to return to their seats, but to no avail. As the members continued their protest, the chairman warned them that raising slogans inside the house is unparliamentary and shameful. As the protests continued, Chairman Naidu adjourned the House to meet on 11th March after Holi.
You don't want discussion, you don't want House to run, you don't want other members to have their say, you have come prepared to disturb the House. That seems to be the situation. The House is adjourned to meet at 11 a.m. on 11th, that is Wednesday.
Rajya Sabha Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu has expressed concern over the continuous disruptions in both houses of parliament over the last few days. He said that the ruling and opposition parties must deliberate and find a meaningful solution that will ensure smooth functioning of the house.
What happened in this house or what is happening in the other house also is a matter of concern. I can only appeal to all, including the government and the opposition, please discuss among yourselves and come to some sort of a meaningful solution to see that the House functions very effectively, because the country is watching what is happening in the Parliament, that too in a budget session. You have seen how many important legislations are coming. I only appeal to all of you, please take care of the same.
Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu also made an observation that the media should have highlighted the statement on coronavirus made by Health Minister Harshvardhan. The Union Minister had made the statement in Rajya Sabha on Thursday. The chairman said it was an issue of public concern, but unfortunately, a section of media did not focus on it. He expressed hope that media houses would consider focusing on such important topics in the future.
On my suggestion, after consultation with the leader of the opposition and other friends, the Minister for Health has made a detailed statement about steps that is being taken or taken and will be taken with regard to the spread of coronavirus. And later, honorable members, they also gave their valuable suggestions. But unfortunately, sections of the media, they did not focus on the important issue, and they were shown more interest on making other things as their headlines, ignoring this. Making other things headlines is their line, we can't help it. But ignoring such a vital, important aspect concerning the people of the country, that's not fair. I hope that they will take care in future.
As proceedings of Rajya Sabha began on Friday, the House gave advance greetings of International Women's Day. Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu congratulated the House and appreciated the contribution of women in every field in life.
Members, March 8th is the International Women's Day, a day to celebrate the social, economic, cultural and political achievements of women throughout the world and honor their resolute determination and incessant efforts to achieve equality, justice, and economic development. It is also a day to reflect upon and ponder over the progress made so far and the impediments that lie in the path of women empowerment.
The chairman said that India has a vibrant history of women's empowerment. However, he pointed that despite equal rights given to women in the constitution and the achievements of women in every field, their safety remains a concern.
Our founding fathers enshrined in the constitution the ideals of gender equality and women empowerment as fundamental of achieving equal rights and dignity for all. Today, despite women registering remarkable progress on all fronts, gender equality and women's safety still remains elusive. Crimes against women are on the rise, the panacea for which lies not only in increasing the quality of policing and tweaking the criminal justice system, but also challenging and changing the deep-seated mindset prevalent in our society.
Chairman Naidu also stressed the need to give equal legislative rights to women, saying that women should be included at every stage of policy formulation and implementation.
Women should be provided with enough opportunities to serve as legislators in the state legislature and parliament. They also need to be included and consulted in every fora for policy formulation and implementation. This will ensure outcomes which are sensitive to the needs of women and provide ample opportunities for them to prosper and contribute to nation building. In spite of all odds, women of our country have come a long way to make their presence felt at the national and international level. It is our duty to keep up this momentum and continue building upon the progress achieved by women. On behalf of all the members and on my behalf, I place on record the appreciation of the services rendered by the women members of this house and also the women citizens of the country, and I wish them all best.
Amid noisy scenes, Upper House conducted formal business. Several ministers tabled papers pertaining to various ministries.
Sri Hardeep Singh Puri.
Sir, with your kind permission, I rise to lay on the table of the House papers pertaining to the Ministry of Commerce and Industry listed against my name as serial number 1 in the revised list of business for today.
Sri Rao Sahib Danwe.
Mahoday. आपके अनुमति से आज की संशोधित कार्य सूची में क्रम संख्या 2 पर आपके नाम के सामने सूचीबद्ध कागजात को सभापति पर रखता हूँ।
श्री पुरुषोत्तम रूपाला।
महोदय, मैं आज के दिनांक 6 मार्च 2020 की राज्यसभा की संशोधित कार्य सूची की क्रम संख्या 3 पर मेरे नाम के समक्ष उल्लेखित दस्तावेजों को सभापति पर रखता हूँ।
साध्वी निरंजन ज्योति।
महोदय, मैं आज की संशोधित कार्य सूची में क्रम संख्या 4 पर मेरे नाम के सामने उल्लिखित दस्तावेज सभा के पटल पर प्रस्तुत करते हैं।
श्री अनुराग सिंह ठाकुर।
चेयरमैन सर, आई राइज टू ले द पेपर्स मेंशन अगेंस्ट माय नेम।
दिस इज ऑल आर नॉट गोइंग ऑन रिकॉर्ड। दिस इज नॉट गोइंग ऑन रिकॉर्ड। यू गो अहेड सर।
सेवरल रिपोर्ट्स ऑफ द डिपार्टमेंट रिलेटेड पार्लियामेंट्री स्टैंडिंग कमिटीज वर आल्सो प्रेजेंटेड।
सर, विद योर काइंड परमिशन,
शेमफुल टू हैव सच स्लोगन्स इन द हाउस।
ए कॉपी ऑफ दी 120th रिपोर्ट Hindi and English.
Please sit down. Sit
of
down.
The department related parliamentary standing committee on health and family welfare on the demand for grants 2020 and 21 of the Ministry of Ayush.
Reports of the parliamentary related parliamentary standing committee on human resources development. Dr. Satyanarayan Jatia.
Mani Sabhapati Mahoday, main Manav Sansadhan Vikas Sambandhi Sansadiy Sthayi Samiti ke nimnlikhit prativedan prastut karta hu. पहला, महिला एवं बाल विकास मंत्रालय के अनुदान मांगों 2021 मांग संख्या 100 के संबंध में एक 314वां प्रतिवेदन, और दूसरा, योग कार्यक्रम और खेल मंत्रालय के अनुदान मांगों 2021 मांग संख्या 101 के संबंध में 315वां प्रतिवेदन। धन्यवाद।
रिपोर्ट्स ऑफ डिपार्टमेंट रिलेटेड पार्लियामेंट्री स्टैंडिंग कमिटी ऑन पर्सनल पब्लिक ग्रीवेंस लॉ एंड जस्टिस। श्री भूपेंद्र यादव।
महोदय, मैं विभाग संबंधित कार्मिक लोक शिकायत विधि और न्याय संबंधी संसदीय समिति के निम्नलिखित प्रतिवेदनों की एक एक प्रति अंग्रेजी और हिंदी में प्रस्तुत करता हूं। कार्मिक लोक शिकायत और पेंशन मंत्रालय के अनुदान संबंधी 2021 से संबंधित समिति का 100वां प्रतिवेदन और विधि एवं न्याय मंत्रालय की अनुदान मांगों 2021 से संबंधित समिति का 101वां प्रतिवेदन।
रिपोर्ट्स ऑफ द डिपार्टमेंट रेड पार्लियामेंट्री स्टैंडिंग कमिटी on science and technology, environment, forest and climate change. Sri Jairam Ramesh. श्री विनय विश्वम ओके गला ठीक है
इट्स ओके
प्लीज
थैंक यू सर फॉर द कंसेंट आल्सो थैंक यू फॉर द होल हाउस फॉर द कंसेंट सर आई राइज टू प्रेजेंट द 326th 327th 328th 329th 330th 331st 332nd reports in English and in Hindi of the department related parliamentary standing committee on science and technology environment forests and climate change on demands for grants 2021 of the departments of atomic energy biotechnology scientific and industrial research science and technology space and ministries of environment and forests and climate change and earth science respectively thank you sir
report of the department related parliament standing committee on petroleum and natural gas sri narayan rao pancharya
महोदय मैं आपकी अनुमति से आज की कार्य सूची में मेरे नाम के समूह यथा सूचीबद्ध पेट्रोलियम और प्राकृतिक गैस संबंधी स्थायी समिति का दूसरा प्रतिवेदन हिंदी तथा अंग्रेजी में सभा पटल पर रखता हूं
एंड विद दिस इट्स अ रैप ऑन दिस एडिशन ऑफ राज्यसभा न्यूज़ थैंक यू सो मच फॉर वाचिंग